Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to make a Drake trap beat in FL Studio. You guys will get the project files. Just go to BusyWorksBeats.com/FL Studio. The link will be in the description. So subscribe and like the video. So let's get straight to it. So firstly, we want to start with the piano. Let's open up Nexus or any kind of Keyscape, whatever you guys have, or Flex even. Go to All. I'm going to go to Piano. And we're going to look for a grand piano type sound. Now we want a harder sound. So let's look for stuff with more like accent on it. It could also have some reverb. What I'm going to do though is play the Phrygian mode. Starts from E. It's all the white notes starting from E. That's where you get that melody from, those first four notes. So I'm just going to play that melody but with subtle variations. Also, the drums are coming from BusyWorksBeats.com. If you guys go to the, where is it at here? BusyWorks Beats. If you go to the Beatmaker Blueprint at BusyWorksBeats.com/Beatmaker. Here we have in the drum kits, if you go to Trap, go to the 808 section, there's 100 some 808s in there. And that's where I picked these 808s from. So I saved you guys time by just picking the sounds. I'm out. Okay, so now we're going to write a melody. So that last note was a little too bright going upwards like that. So let's hit Control Q and let's pull that note down, an octave control down. Even that's a little musical. Let's go to D to see if we can create more tension. A little more resolving there. What we're gonna do now is just record a contrast layer. So there's four layers to melody. You have the rhythmic layer, the harmony layer, the contrast layer, and you have what's called a top line. For this type of beat, the top line is going to be the vocal melody, not the piano melody. But let's create a contrast lower frequency. Now there I had to use a different octave because my keyboard didn't go all the way up. Let's hit Control Q, quantize, hit Control down. Okay, so that piano has a lot of weight to it, so we want to make sure that doesn't get in the way of the 808. You could pull it up an octave and then run it through halftime, or we could just add an EQ and just kind of shave off the low end. It depends on the 808. We're not going to worry about that yet. Now let's draw in the snare pattern, and we're going to turn the metronome on if you guys can't count music, and just click in a pattern here. We're going to start with the snares because it's very bouncy, so it goes 1, 2, 3. But it needs more energy, so let's add ta, 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 which is basically tresillo. So tresillo is ta, 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 ta. Okay, it's just offset. Also, we can up the BPM a little bit. Okay, now let's do the hi-hats. Simple hi-hats is right-click, fill each two. Okay, so now we have the bounce to the beat. We're probably going to change something about the snare, maybe. Let's hit Control-B to latch pace. Let's go to pattern 3, and now let's add in our 808. I don't have a kick yet. Program these 808s, and let's just turn these down 3 through 8. Pretty loud, so I'm going to turn them down temporarily. So now I'm just trying to feel the 808. Also, another trick is to go to the envelope tab, turn on your hold parameter, turn everything else down. And if you want everything the same length, you can go to stretch mode. I learned that from Larry. Hard to hear this tone, so what we can do is go up an octave, just right click your typing keyboard. Let's go up an octave to C5. I want like two different 808s. Let's record this one. go into the 808. Let's hit Alt Q to quantize these notes to the grid. Just hit Alt Q. Control Q quantizes it to the snap to grid. Because we play faster notes, I know that my snap to grid isn't going to measure those notes. So let's hit Alt Q. And I think one last note might be. I think we're going to stick with the 1808 for now. Sounds pretty cool. Just changed up some of the patterns over here to make it bouncy. So in the second half, we want something to change. We could take out elements, add effects. We don't always have to add more instruments. What I'm going to do though is add a hi-hat roll from the other hi-hat. So we're just going to add the pattern to the playlist and listen in real time as we create the hi-hat rolls. Just double click to go inside, right click, go to piano roll. Now we can add in notes here. And the new FL in the bottom left, you have what's called note repeat. So you could just pull this up to change out the styles of chopping. It's a lot easier than hitting Alt U and going through all that. But if you're not in the new versions, hit Alt U and change the time multiplier. So it looks like this. Let's change the time multiplier. So now we need a kick. So I'm going to go through. I have a trusted kick. Again, you guys will get the project file, so don't try to memorize every single step that I'm doing. So just the general basis here is that we're lining up everything. Okay, so let's turn this. And let's go to a new pattern. Let's go to pattern 5. We're just going to do tresillo, which is doom, 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 but just spread out. Turn this kick down a little bit. So we're not going to change the drums up too much because that'll throw off the rap. When I mix this, I'll crank the kick up, but right now I'm not trying to slam the kick. Let's make one small change. This may or may not, you know, be worth it, but let's hit Control G. Let's double click in here, hit Control Up. And now we're going to go to the piano roll, right click, clone the piano so it creates an exact duplicate of that plugin settings. Hit Control X, Control V to paste it in, hit Control L to send it to a new mixer insert. So now we have the same piano duplicated. We're going to run it through some effects here. So Kilohertz Reverser is one of my favorites for like darker melodies, as well as the Kilohertz Pitch Shifter. And you can combine that with halftime to slow it down so it creates a unique sound. So let's hear what this sounds like by itself. This adds a little more energy. Let's go to the pitch shifter. And if you want more grain, this also adds like a texture to your piano. Turn up the grain size and then raise your octave here by going plus 12. For less grain, just pull down the grain. And then we can run this through halftime to make a really unique combo. Load up halftime, halftime. Gross Beat also has a halftime preset under momentary. So we're going to do this. Chop out the lows. Might be too much movement here. Yeah, it's too much movement, so let's pull this to 100%. I don't think we need halftime. Let's just hear it in context, though. Kind of slows the beat down too much. We don't want it to be super slow. Also, I don't think we need pitch shifter, but that's there if you guys want. So this way we're creating changes. Okay, so what we're gonna do is really just copy and paste this. If we need more drums, we could just copy our drums over. So I'll play this beat and then I'm gonna go record some ideas possibly and then mix it a little bit more. Even if I don't do vocals, I'll at least mix this beat.